Let us see some directions, some typical cases when the magnet is moved towards the coil. In this figure 1, there is a magnet with north-south pole as shown. This is velocity, means it is brought, velocity vector direction is this, it is brought near the coil. So in this situation, when you are bringing this coil, when you are bringing this magnet near the coil, this near end will behave like a north pole and the far end will behave like a south pole, and the current will try to move away from the north pole. It will be like this. So this is the B vector. So if you want to apply the right hand thumb rule, in this situation this magnetic field, because of this coil, will try to oppose the movement of this magnet. Because this magnet is trying to increase the flux, the magnetic field of the coil will try to oppose the change. So if you want to apply the right hand thumb rule, we should use our thumb in such a way that the original B direction is this. We should put the thumb in the opposing direction. Then you see the fingers. The fingers are making an anti-clockwise sense. The fingers are making an anti-clockwise sense. That is what is this. This is a anti-clockwise sense. In the next scenario, it is happening like this. In this situation, the north-south pole orientation is like this. Velocity vector is towards the coil. When it is trying to come near the coil, this coil will behave as if the north pole is this side and south pole is on the other side. So north and south are attracted. You will feel as if the current direction is towards the south pole, like as shown in the figure. In this situation, if you want to apply the right hand thumb rule, you have to use thumb rule in this way. The thumb should indicate the magnetic field direction. You can see the fingers, they are coming in, the fingers are coming in clockwise direction, isn't it? So this is how this movement is clockwise. Okay, in both situations you have to put the finger in such a way that it is opposing the magnetic field.